Most of us have had the experience of dealing with those who claim the name of the Lord, but who at the same time actually don't receive the love of the truth. But we know that actually the truth is of critical importance. You'll know that a little while ago I did a video about Benny the Liar versus the truth. And I posted a clip, I borrowed a clip, short brief bit, of Benny Hinn talking about how more people are saved in the Roman Catholic Mass, or the Holy Eucharist, where they've switched the name carefully, hoping that people don't notice he's talking about the blasphemous rite of the Mass, that more people are healed, saved and delivered in that horror, that blasphemous rite, than are actually saved in Christian churches and delivered and what have you. Now that was a shocking, wicked, putrid lie. Completely wicked. Actually, you will never see salvation in the satanic Pope religion. People are never healed and delivered. In fact, you can see videos on YouTube, and I've seen them in the past, of some demonized woman being brought to the Pope to be exorcised. And there is the Pope of the time, I think it was Ratty in the Vatty, I'm not entirely sure, it certainly isn't the current one, Frankie in the Frock. But nevertheless, and he's sitting there going, get out, get out, get out, and whatever. And of course there is no effect whatsoever, because quite simply he's not one of God's people. He doesn't have the power or the authority. But the issue here is, what's the truth for you and for me? I received the love of the truth that I might be saved. Now salvation, our God, is salvation from sin unto God, now before you die. Or as the scripture says elsewhere, now is the day of salvation, right? Okay. Not though church people care what God says and what scripture says, of course, they've got their own lies that they adhere to instead. But nevertheless, did you receive the love of the truth? Did you? That you might be saved from sin unto God before you die. Now you've seen Benny Hinn telling shocking lies, and what leaves me absolutely speechless is people will sit there and take it. A little while ago, you'll remember Kenneth Copeland bringing in a Catholic priest to talk about church unity in a pastor's conference run by Kenneth Copeland. And there he was talking about church unity and all the rest of it. Todd White is also doing it, talking about how the church will be united. Well, it probably will, but it's nothing to do with the ecclesia of God, because God's people won't have anything whatever to do with that which is Antichrist, okay? But nevertheless, I'm astounded at the sheer volume of lies. But not just the volume of lies, but how people will just take the lies on board. Just the other day on Benny Hinn's new channel, he's gone from God TV, by the way, and without any announcements, of course, but he's gone from God TV quietly. He's abandoned people like Wendy Alec, who used to run the thing. And now it's probably, he considers it a toxic brand, and he's now moved in with a black, I think Nigerian, I don't know what he is, Pastor Chris something or other, unpronounceable surname. And he runs this thing called Love World USA. Love World is a so-called Christian TV channel. Okay, and it's Benny Hinn and Pastor Chris whatever doing their stuff, and other people they invite to come along. It is nauseating. It really is appalling. But that's what they want to do. It's not for me to go sorting them out. But I heard Benny Hinn on there saying the other day, speaking to this Hindu man on the stage, he so-called healed this man's grandson, I think he was. And he was Benny Hinn is saying to this guy, God loves Hindus. God loves Muslims. God loves Christians. As though they're the same. They're not. at all. That was an appalling, monumental lie. Absolutely monumental lie. Totally and utterly disgusting and abhorrent to the gospel of Jesus Christ. Why do these people take it on board? This is what astonishes me. It used to leave me completely dumbfounded. I look at these people and wonder, what on earth is going on? That is a lie so big, so blatant, and so obvious that for some bizarre reason people lose the capacity to believe it is lies because they don't believe Pastor Benny would lie that big. And they will follow men, which is why Scripture says, be ye not followers of men. They will follow men and go off after all kinds of lies through men, but they won't receive the love of the truth. If you and I stood in those same meetings and we said, the issue before God is sin. Jesus Christ came in to save men out of sin, and you are to leave the world behind and everything of the world, love not the world or things that be in the world, as John wrote. And you are to move into the pure and perfect kingdom of God now before you die. Live in it and leave behind everything of the world. What do you think the reaction would be in the likes of Benny Hinn meetings? I think they'd probably run out of the room screaming, wouldn't they? Just look at all those people in Benny Hinn meetings, in Kenneth Copeland meetings, in Todd White meetings, who are hearing crashing lies which are in defiance of well-known Christian doctrine. Here we are 500 years roughly after the end of the Reformation, where God put the Catholics' light, the satanic church of the Catholics' light, in between the Christian killing Catholics, and so that God could work, because of course the Anglicans couldn't be seen to be just like a bunch of murderous pagan Catholics, could they? And here we are 500 years later, and the new Catholics, like Benny Hinn, Todd White, and all these women screechers, and you know, and all the rest of them, Kenneth Copeland, all these people are now reversing the Reformation as hard as they can go, probably because they've lost their nerve. Isn't it strange? They've probably lost their nerve to stand for the truth because they want acceptance. That brings more money. And they like their money, these people, don't they? Sadly, the truth of the matter is quite simply that Roman Catholicism is satanic. It is Satan's finest work since the Garden of Eden. By setting up a fake church around about 300 AD, it didn't exist before then, and then started as Rome militarily and political and what have you as a organization subsided, then Rome spiritual took over, Satan took over, running the whole of Europe effectively and wider parts of the world, using the Antichrist and the fake religion of Rome to do that. So everybody knows that. That should be well known truth. In this country, to be a Roman Catholic was and is a shame and a disgrace. Roman Catholicism is revolting filth, but sadly, look at the size of the problem today. How many people don't know anymore why Catholicism is satanic? I even have some people who are former Baptists known to me, were in the fellowship years ago when I was going to a fellowship. And this older couple, as they are now, the woman who's always gung-ho religious and church and all the rest of it, hadn't seen me for ages, and bumped into her one day and, oh, hello, and, you know, how are you doing us there? And then she switches immediately in about two or three sentences. Of course, Catholics are Christians. They just don't do things the way we do them. Now, isn't that interesting? See, she knew immediately by the Spirit in me that what she got was lies, and here she is trying to justify her lies. Adolf Hitler said something to the effect that if you tell lies big enough and long enough, people lose the capacity to believe that you're lying and they'll believe you. And that's exactly what's happening here. Benny Hinn is telling shocking and appalling lies, and loads of people believe him. Loads of people believe Todd White because he has a trendy dropout's hairdo and refuses to move from the ways of the world to the ways of God. He wants a good slap. He needs the elders to get hold of him and discipline him. And if he won't do that, then he's out of the fellowship and he doesn't come amongst us. However, now monumental lies are being told out there. And you and I, well, we just walk away. It's not our job to fix these people. I mean, any more than we either fix the Catholics or the Anglicans or the Baptists or anything like that. It's totally and absolutely wrong. They refuse to do anything else but wrong. Well, that's their choice. Okay, goodbye. We're gone. We'll leave you to play your wrong as much as you like, and we aren't going to get into bed with your wrong. But here we've got campaigners for filthy lies and the reversing of the Reformation. Benny Hinn, Kenny Copeland, Todd White, I have heard say it. I have no doubt that the others like Cashflow Dollar and all the other lying multimillionaire wicked hypocrites who dare tell shocking lies against the work of God and the Reformation. Not though people who were doing the Reformation were right themselves, you understand. I mean, he did use Nebuchadnezzar, but was Nebuchadnezzar one of his people? No. But nevertheless, here we have these people telling shocking lies. Now, what's going to be their end? Well, eternal fire, of course. There's no salvation from sin in anything else but the truth. You shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. Monumental lies will bring you into bondage. So you have Copeland, Hagen, Hinn, Sorello, Todd White, you know, what's his name, of Hillsong, and people like Rick Warren are bringing millions into appalling spiritual bondage. Okay, most of the people who follow them are not God's people to start with, I concede. But think about it. And we are absolutely stunned that people would say such shocking, filthy lies in the name of Jesus, aren't we? But I'm afraid that's the era we're in. And this is the satanic era, therefore. Satan is the father of lies. And if these people are telling shocking lies, they're not in perfect accord with the will and the truth of God, then they're children of the devil playing church, aren't they? How utterly sad. But don't you get sucked in. Don't just because the majority of people who supposedly Bible-based Christians are doing and saying shocking wickednesses, don't go along with them, will you? Don't get tempted and drawn off. If you have to stand completely alone, you can. You have Christ for yourself. We all do. The church people don't. They have Christ external. We have Christ internal. They have Christ up there on his throne, which is why they're always raising their hands up to heaven. In the New Testament, we have Christ in us, the hope of glory, and they're not in the New Testament. They have no idea yet that they're not in the New Testament, but by goodness me, they're just about to find out.